डियर स्टूडेंट्स, सी लास्ट टाइम वी कंप्लीटेड थियरी पार्ट एंड वी स्टार्टेड एग्जांपल्स ऑफ लेसन नंबर 5, दैट इज लॉज इन मोशन. नाउ लास्ट टाइम वी डिस्कस्ड क्वेश्चन रिलेटेड टू मोशन ऑफ कनेक्टेड बॉडीज ऑल्सो. एंड आई ऑल्सो गिव यू वन क्वेश्चन इन विच वी यूज स्टडीड इक्विलिब्रियम ऑफ फोर्सेस. सी दैट वॉज अवर एग्जाम्पल 5.6 के. एंड आई गिव यू वन question for solving. I hope all of you have solved that. Now we proceed further. See, our next example is example number 5.7. See, the question says the maximum acceleration of a train now let us say the train is moving in this direction. See, a box lying on the floor. Let us say, see, the box lying in the floor remains stationary. Now, as I discussed earlier, the friction force prevents impending motion. Okay, now see the train pull of the engine force is F. So that is F is equal to ma. Now see, the frictional force Fs max should be less than mu s into n. Now what should be? N here is mg. Okay. Now what should be the minimum acceleration? Okay. So this is also force. See, this is a pull of the engine. See, in that case, if I write in terms of inequality, it will be equal to mu s into m into g. Okay. Now g is a gravitational acceleration. See, mu is given as 0.15 here, and for g value we have taken as 10 meter per second square. So our equation will become So the minimum acceleration of the train will be 1.5 meter per second square. So this is how we relate the friction force with the acceleration. Now this is about the example 5.7. See, the question says what should be the minimum acceleration of a train such that the blocks remain lying on the floor of the train remain stationary. See, the frictional force, as we have discussed, mu s is should be less than mu s into n. N is nothing but mg, that is n is the gravitational, n is equal to mg, that is mg is the gravitational force. Now for inequality we consider ma is mu s into mg. So value of A we should get as 1.5 meter per second square. Now next is example number 5.8. Okay, example number 5.8. Now this is we have discussed earlier, but I will take again. Now we have to obtain the coefficient of friction in terms of theta, that is the angle of inclination. Now here, what are the forces acting on the block? See, the weight of the block is mg, that is in the downward direction. Now see, by geometry this is 90, this will be 90 minus theta, so this will be theta again. Now what are the components of the force? This will be mg cos theta. By the definition, this will be mg sin theta. Now see, when block was on the horizontal surface, mg is balanced by n. So here n is the normal force. See, the mg sin theta will produce impending motion, but as I told, the frictional force always in the opposite direction of the motion F. So if the block remains stationary, in that case, for see, this Fs is nothing but mg sin theta, or we can say F, and n is equal to mg cos theta. Now if I take the ratio mg sin theta upon Now recall our equation FF max mu s into n FS max upon n is mu s. Okay, so if I compare, see we get mu s is equal to tan theta. Okay, now see here, theta value is given as 15 degree, tan 15 is 0.27 value, you can see from the tables. So, if the angle inclination exceed 15 degree, the block will come down. Okay, so the condition that the block will remain stationary is up to here, that is coefficient of friction will be mu s, that is equal to 0.27. Okay, now see the angle at which the block, see suppose is the horizontal block is lying like this, it is a stationary, so what we see, mg is balanced by n. Okay, now if I put on a slope and keep on increasing the slope, the minimum angle for which the block will start coming down along the slope is called the angle of repose. Okay, so this is about the example number 5.8. Now see our next example, that is example number 5.9. Okay, now here is a system of a block and a pulley. See, connected by a string like this. Okay. Now let us say this mass is m1. M1 is 3 kg. Okay, g value we have to take as 10. Now we have to calculate the tension in the string. Now here we will take the help of free body diagram, okay, that we have discussed earlier. Now what are the forces here? M1G. So 30. First we consider forced body diagram or a free body diagram for M1. So what are the forces here? M1G minus T is equal to M1A. Now what is value of M1G here? It is 30 minus T. M1 value is 3. See, this will be our first equation. Now similarly, FBD for M2. Okay, now see the coefficient of friction is given as 0.04. Okay, now see, because this weight, the M2 is going to move in the right hand side. Okay, so the frictional force always in the opposite direction of the motion. So what are the forces here on M2? See, this will be T, F equal to mu s M2G. Okay, now mu s is given as 0.04. Okay, mu s is given as 0.04, G is 10. Okay, so this will be 4/100. So 8 Newton is a friction force. Okay, now so if I substitute the value here, it will be T minus 8 is equal to M2A. That is T minus 8 is M2 is how much? 20A. See our first equation, 30 minus T is 3A. Now this is our second equation. If I solve, 22 is equal to, A is common, 20 plus 3, 23A. So A is equal to 22/23. Okay, A value is 22/23. Okay, so this is how we can obtain the value of A. Now suppose we have to find out T, we can use any one of the equation. Now we use this equation, 30 minus T is 3A. So 30 minus T is 3A is 0.96. 30 minus, see 3 into 0.96. Okay, that is 0.96. Okay, so this is how we can solve the example. You can see this is a simple question which take the help of free body diagram, okay, or force body diagram. So this was our example 5.9. Now next is our example 5.10. Now see, the question says a cyclist speeding at the speed of 18 km per hour on a circular level track of radius 3 meter, V is 18 km per hour. Now see, the coefficient of friction is 0.1. Okay, we have to check whether the cycle will slip while taking the turn or not. Now this is a case of motion of a vehicle on a level circular track. Okay, motion of the vehicle on a level circular. See, the maximum safe speed is mu s into r into g, 0.1, r is 3 and g is 9.8. Okay, that turns out to be yeah, that value we obtain as 2.71 meter per second. Okay, now this is the maximum permissible safe speed, but see, our vehicle or our cyclist moves speed larger than the maximum permissible safe speed, so that's why he will slip from the path while taking the turn. So here V, that is 5 meter per second, is more than, therefore cyclist slip from the path while okay. So this is how we can solve this example number 5.1. Now see, the 5.11 we have discussed while taking the theory of the banked curved road, that is the motion of the vehicle on a circular road with a slope. Okay, so now next is our example number 5.12. Now this one is very interesting. See, a block, a wooden block is there. Okay, mass 2 kg. Okay, now on a kept on a surface, soft horizontal floor. Okay, now see, a metallic cylinder of 25 kg mass. Yeah, a metallic cylinder of 25 kg mass we have kept here. Now what will be the common acceleration with all these penetrates? Why? Because see, this is a wooden block, the surface is smooth or a soft surface. Okay, so when we place a cylinder here, see, it will give the downward force. We have to find out what will be the reaction, what will be the reaction now on the system. Now see what is the downward force here total. Okay, what is the downward force here? See, 25 okay, that is 270 Newton. Now let us say reaction is R dash. Okay, R dash is a reaction. Okay, again we use the G values given as 10. Now the question says that when the metallic cylinder is placed, the system moves with the acceleration of 0.1 meters seconds per second square. Okay, now G we have used in calculating the weight of the system, that is 25 plus 227. So the net force is 270 Newton in the outward direction. Let us say the reaction offered by the soft horizontal surface is this. Because it's a soft horizontal surface, the system block moves with a acceleration of 0.1 meter per second square. See, our question is to find out the reaction. Okay, we use Newton's second law of motion. Okay, here see net force is equal to mass into acceleration. See what are the forces here? 270 minus R dash. Okay, is equal to what is the system is again M1 plus M2. A. What is A is acceleration given. So 270 minus R dash M1 plus M2 we are having. See the acceleration is given as 0.1. So see the 270 minus R dash is again 2.7. So R dash we can obtain is 267. Okay, so that is a reaction offered by the flow. So here the question is again like this. See here 2 kg block. See when a metallic cylinder of 25 kg is placed on it, because of the force and the surface is smooth, the system moves with the acceleration of 0.1 meter per second square. See, we have to calculate the reaction offered by the surface on the system of block. Now see the weight is mg, m1 plus m2 into g, that is 270, 25 plus 2 into g is 10. Reaction let us say is r dash, that is we have to find out. And the acceleration of the system is a there, a that is given as 0.1. So it is m1 plus m2 into a. So by substituting the value, we get r dash value is 267.3 Newton. Now see, with that we come to end of example parts. Okay, now we take exercise numericals. See, some of them are theoretical, okay, but we take that one which are important. Now let us say our exercise sum number 0.5 okay. See, a pebble of mass 0.5 it is thrown in vertically upward direction. Okay, we have to calculate what are the force first. Now see, the pebble is thrown like this, but see the gravitational force is always in the downward direction. So G value is given as 10. See the gravitational acceleration always in the downward direction. So first 5 Newton. Now the arrow indicates the force is in downward direction. Okay, so when the pebble is thrown upward direction, the gravitational force, the force acting is in the downward direction. Secondly, during is the downward motion. See, after reaching to maximum height, it will come down. See the GL again. So force is equal to mg. This shows the forces in downward direction. Third, at the highest point, okay? See, at highest point, its velocity is zero, okay? See here, why? See, when it is moves upward, it is a retarded motion. But again, at highest point, g also will be there. G do not become zero. G is 10 meter per second square. So the highest point also force is equal to mg. Okay, so this is the force acting at the highest point. Now this is about the example number 5.2. Now see the next example, next exercise numerical is 5.3. See, a stone mass is 0.1 kg. Okay, now see a person sitting in a stationary train, drop a stone from the window. What is the force acting? Okay, so when it is thrown from a window, the force acting is F is equal to mg. G is 10, force is 1 meter. Okay, that is in downward direction. See, first case the train is stationary. Second case, the train moves with constant speed of okay. And then earlier the train was stationary, person sitting in the train was dropping the stone. Now the train move with the constant speed of 36 km per hour. During that motion, see the person dropped the stone. But here, once the stone is dropped, only force acting on the stone is gravitational force. So F is equal to mg. So in that case also the force will be 1 newton. And the third, the train accelerated motion. Third case, let us say, acceleration of 1 meter per second square, and the person dropped the stone. Okay, so in that case, during the acceleration of the train, see the force acting on the stone will be ma. Okay, but see, train is having accelerated motion and the stone is dropped. Only force, once it has left the train, okay, once it is dropped from the train, only force acting is gravitational force. Once dropped, force acting is mg. Now it has nothing to do with the acceleration of the train, 0.1 meter. So that is the force acting on the stone from a train accelerating with a 1 meter per second square. Okay, so this is about the exercise sum number 5.3. Now see, our next example is example number, exercise sum number 5.5. Now see this 5.4 that I will discuss, see in the lesson number 6, that is work, power, energy also. There we have a similar example. Now exercise number 5.5. See a 20 kg mass is moving with the initial velocity of 15 meter per second. Okay, the retarding force of 15 meter is applied. We have to find out in how much time. Okay, the object will stop. Now see, here is a retarding force. First we find out the acceleration and then we can find out the time. See, our equation is F is equal to ma, a is equal to F upon m. Okay, 50, mass is 20, so 2.5. but this is retardation. Okay, this is retardation. See, here the block stops, so final velocity will be 0. Now our equation, V is equal to V naught plus AB. See, here we have obtained the value of acceleration is 2.5, but when we use in the equation, we have to take negative sign. Why? Because the force is a retarding force. See, the final velocity is 0, 15. Okay, so T is, okay, so time value will get 6 seconds. Okay, so the block will stop in 6 seconds. So this is how we can solve the question. That is example, exercise sum number 5.1. Now see our next question. See, a constant force act on a body such that during that force the velocity changes from 2 meter per second to 3.5 meter per second. In 25 seconds, see, the velocity changes from 2 meter per second to 3.5. The mass of the object is 3 kg. See, we have to find out the force acting. Again, see, we have to use equation F is equal to ma. The acceleration will be V minus V0 upon T. Velocity is 3.5. V0 is 2. Time is 25. Okay, so yes, see, the acceleration is 0.06 meter per second square. Now we use the equation F is equal to ma. Mass is how much? 3. Okay, so the force acting is 0.8 meter. Now see exercise number 5.7. Okay, now see, a block is subjected to two perpendicular forces, okay, of 8 Newton and 6 Newton. See, we can represent like this. See, mass of the block is 5 kg. See, here two forces act perpendicular to each other, that is a right angle. So what is the resultant force? Okay, now here two forces are at right angle to each other, so we can use Pythagoras theorem. So resultant force be F, we can write F1 is 8 Newton, F2 is 6 Newton. See, by using Pythagoras, F is equal to now we are familiar with the Pythagoras triplets, force is 10 Newton. Now see, the equation is F is equal to ma, a is F upon m. So the acceleration produces 0.5 meter per second square. So this is about exercise number 5.7. Now see, next is exercise number 5.8. Okay, now see, a vehicle is moving with a speed of 36 km per hour. Now VC is a child, okay. So he applies brake and stops in 4 seconds. Here, the vehicle stops in 4 seconds. Now, see the total mass of the vehicle and the driver is 465 kg, 400. See, vehicle mass and the driver, so total mass we can say 400. Now see, 36 km per hour we have to convert in meter per second. Here we have to find out the retarding force. See, the acceleration is V minus V0 upon T. Here the velocity decreases, so that's why we have a negative acceleration. Now see, the force acting is F is equal to ma. Here we have considered total mass. See, retardation is 4.2.5, so the total force will be, okay, that will be, okay, minus 1162 point. So this is how we can calculate. See, the initial velocity is given. See, after applying the brake, see, the vehicle stops, that is, in time is given as 4 seconds. Okay, total mass of the vehicle and the driver is 40 plus 400 plus 60 that we have obtained. Now we have obtained the value of acceleration, and by using the equation F is equal to ma, we can obtain the value of retarding force. So these are the sums of some exercise numericals. See, next time we'll continue with the exercise numerical. Right now we stop here. Thank you.